Minecraft was just one of those bits of gaming genius. I think you can sum up the appeal of Minecraft effectively by just saying it's Lego of video games.
Minecraft is an open-world game which lets players shape their environment by placing or destroying blocks. It's easy, it's creative, and it's social.
The beautiful thing with Minecraft is that you see people playing together to create something, to build some massive project. People coming together to build replicas of the Starship Enterprise and stuff like that within Minecraft. And that's a lovely thing, because most of the time in games, people come together to destroy stuff and each other.
Minecraft became a hit, selling over 33 million copies. And its most enthusiastic fans are children.
Children can interact with Minecraft, and it allows them to be creative in a way that nothing else does. Like, reading a book is great, it's wonderful, but it doesn't allow them to be part of that fantasy. Minecraft does.
And they create these huge worlds for themselves, these huge structures, not because someone is telling them to, but because they want to. And they're probably learning so much about teamwork and design and architecture and the environment just through playing this game.
You get lots of teachers now, geography teachers use Minecraft to get children to design villages. So you get physics teachers now using Minecraft to teach kids about simple mechanisms.
And finally, I made it work. The Minecraft escalator.
It really communicates to kids. Like, my children, my sons play Minecraft a lot. My older son is on the autism spectrum. To him, Minecraft is so valuable because it's a world of logic and creativity which he immediately understands. And this is the same for all children. Like, it's really helped my son, in a lot of ways, kind of express himself, which is really profoundly important. You know, I'd love to shake the maker of that game by the hand, because I think he's kind of changed my son's life.